Welcome you students, in this video session I come up with another question from conic curves. So take a question, trace the conic section when the distance of focus from the directrix is 30 mm and eccentricity is 1. Name the curve, also draw the tangent and normal 50 mm from the axis. Okay, so the given data, it is given the distance of focus from the directrix, that means CF is given as 30 mm, okay, and the eccentricity is 1. In other name I can say eccentricity as unity. Unity is equivalent to 1. Okay, so fine. So in this there is no direct say draw the parabola or draw the hyperbola or draw the ellipse, am I right? So here just it is given trace the conic section, something like that, am I right? So first try to identify the curve. I said you in the introduction part, we must identify the curve by using eccentricity value, right? So here the eccentricity is 1. We know the eccentricity value, if it is greater than 1, it's gonna be the hyperbola. If the eccentricity is less than 1, it's gonna be the what? Ellipse. If the eccentricity is equal to 1 or unity, it's gonna be a parabola, right? So the given curve here is parabola. The given curve is parabola. So now we're going to start to construct the parabola. So for which, first go for a vertical line. Go for a vertical line, which is D dash and D, nothing but a directrix line. The vertical line is nothing but a directrix. And take a C point at the mid of your D dash to D and go for a perpendicular line to the directrix, for which keep your protractor as this manner and read 90 degree, and go for a line, you will get like this. Okay, so it's just 90 degree to this directrix, 90 degree to this directrix. This is nothing but axis, so you can denote it as A. Okay, so after completing it, how to point out the focus on the axis? So here about the axis, about the focus, we have the measurement from the directrix, it is given as 30. So take your scale from the C, measure it and just take the focus. You are keeping your scale in the horizontal manner. From the C you are taking the measurement 30 and you are making the point focus. Okay, right. So after completing the focus, you have to just have to get idea to keep the vertex point. Okay, so always the vertex idea will get from where? Yes, from the eccentricity, am I right? So here the eccentricity, in the sense we know E is equal to VF divided by VC, right? The distance from the moving point to the focus and the distance between the moving point and what? The directrix, right? So here it is mentioned as 1. If it is 1, I can say in the denominator it carries 1, right? So in the division, if you add it, the numerator and denominator, we get 1 plus 1 as 2 divisions. Fine, we get the 2 divisions. Okay, it says, clearly says, the distance between CF is divided into 2, or distance between C to F consists of 2 divisions, something like that, it clearly saying for us. So we have to divide this CF into two, okay? So it's a 30 mm. If you divide it by 2, we get 15 mm, okay? We get 15 mm. So just measure 15 mm and have a marking, you can divide this CF into two equal parts. So we have two divisions, right? So afterwards, I can say, in order to take the wettest point, how to make use of eccentricity. Here it's showing the exact things, how we have to go with the things. It is given from the focus to the wettest as one division, right? From the wettest to the focus, it is with one division. So from the focus, measure one. So exactly we get here, okay? So from it, in order to point out the guide line and guide points, how to take the vertical line, just a 90 degree line to the axis, okay? Just like this. And afterwards, just measure V to F in your compass and place VS center and just go for an arc. It moves like this, and intersect with the vertical line. It is your guide point. If you draw a line connecting C and S, you get a line which is called a guide line. Fine. So next, we need to find all the points, moving points, to trace the parabola. So here, what I'm going to do is, from the vertex, I'm going to divide the axis into equal parts with 10 mm, okay? 10 mm. I'm going to measure 10 mm in my compass, and from the vertex, I'm going to have a point, and from the end, which I have taken here, next I'm going to cut a point in the axis. Again, I'm going to do it. Since it is a parabola, 5 or 6 consecutive lines are more than enough to trace out the shape. In the ellipse, we need minimum 10 to 15. So here, 5 to 6 line is more than enough for us to trace out the curve, right? So I have taken the points and go for a 90 degree line with respect to axis. For this axis, you have to take 90 degree line. So it goes like this. The separation goes like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So it goes like this. Okay. So I can denote name. This is a 1, 1' first line. So for the second, 2, 2', and for the third, 3, 3'. This is a fourth line, 4, 4', and this is a fifth line. I going to take as 5, 5'. Okay. And next thing is, it is perfectly, the construction work is all right to pick all the points, okay? So just hereafter, what we're going to do is, the procedure, it is common procedure for picking all the points in the conic section. That means we're going to fix center as focus. We're going to fix the center as focus, and then we're going to measure the radius. That means for the first point, we're going to measure 1 to 1', okay? So what I'm going to do is just use your compass and measure 1 to 1' and keep focus as a center and go for a cut mark in the respective line. This is the first, we're going to pick the first point, so just cut mark in the first line. So here you will get, with the same measurement, cut it in the lower portion. It comes like this, okay? And next, the same procedure you have to follow for the rest of the consecutive lines which we have done here, right? So take the measurement 2 to 2' and keep at the point focus okay, keep the FS center and just give a cut mark in the respective line, that means the second 2 to 2 dash line. So just have a cut mark and just come to the lower portion, trace it like this, okay. You are following for the rest of the lines 2 2 dash, we have completed 3 dash as well, 4 to 4 dash as well, 5 to 5 dash, we are going to follow the same procedure, okay. If you follow it, you will get the trace like this. Always the focus is fixed as a center, no confusion should be there, always the focus is a center and measure the respective line and just cut it, have a cut mark in the respective line, okay. So I have taken the points, so this is the first point, okay. I can say this is P1 dash and this is a P1 and this is a P2 dash, this is a P2 and this is a P2 dash, and here it is P3 and here it is P3 dash, and here P4 and here P5, the same likewise, P4 dash and P5 dash is here. If you draw a very thin line with the help of 2H pencil, you could able to trace out the curve, that means our profile. So I'm starting with the wet edge and just with a smooth hand go for a thin line and connect all those picked point like this. It's the same manner, come to the bottom, start from the wet edge and move it to the rest of the points which you have taken, you will conclude this shape. Once you are satisfied with your curve, okay, so you can take your HP pencil. Till now we never used the HP pencil, now it's time to use the HP pencil. Since the profile should be a dark one, take the HP pencil and go for a dark line. Just make a profile, just make this curve as a dark one, since it is our object, only the object line should be a dark one in the engineering graphics, okay. So go for a dark one, okay. Now the profile is okay, and next also here added with the question, name the curve, okay, fine, we can capture it later, and draw the tangent and normal 50 mm from the axis. The normal and tangent should be drawn, but the condition is given, not at all given at any place. In the last question we have placed the point at any point in the curve, right? Here the condition is given 50 mm from the axis, okay. So for which take the scale, since it is taken from the axis, see this is the axis line, this is the axis line, so take the scale and just measure 50 mm approximately. For understanding, I going to take this is my 50 mm, okay, this is my 50 mm, and keep your scale vertical manner and just keep it like this. Your scale should be right perpendicular to the axis and just try to move it, slide it as this manner, and just see where it matches with the curve. So for me it is getting here. If you are drawing with the exact measurement, you may get a different spot, okay. For me, I'm getting here when I slide it like this, okay. So this is my point P. This is my point P. I have picked the point, okay, right. And next, the same procedure as we followed in the ellipse, how to take a line from the point P to focus. So just with the help of scale, just join P to F, and then how to keep your protractor in the line F to P, make F a center and just have 90 degree measurement and direct the line to directrix D dash to D. So you will get the intersection point on the directrix. From that you have to take a line to the point P, that will be your what, tangent, am I right? That means the line comes like this, like this, tangent in the sense the line passing through the outer periphery of the curve, right? So just passing through the outer periphery of the curve, this is your tangent, This is your tangent. Tangent. So you can write as T dash and T. Now normal, we have to draw. It is so easy. It is a 90 degree line with the tangent. So keep your protractor and make P a center and go for measurement 90 and just go for a dark line. As far as the conic curves concern, always three things should be a dark one. That means one is a profile, your curve, and next is the tangent, and next your normal n dash. Okay, fine. This is a 90 degree line. You can note like this. Fine. So you have completed it, and two things remaining. One is dimensioning, and next one is a note. And also here extra question is there, name the curve, something like that. So we have to give the title too, right? So three things we have to follow here. Fine. Let's start with the dimensions. We have the measurement CF as 30. So C is here. From the C, just drop a perpendicular line, okay? And from the focus, just drop a perpendicular line, and then take a dimensioning line. It should be just parallel to it, okay? And capture with a filled arrow at both ends and write above the line as 30. As 30. So any other dimensions? Yes. Here in the tangent and normal, 50 mm from the axis, right? So this is the axis. So take the horizontal line. So here I have. So where is it? So here, right? So from it, just take a horizontal line. It should be parallel to the axis. Maintain it parallel, and then just have a vertical line like this and write above it 50. Okay, write above your line as 50. Okay, and next the note should be captured. The notes is about TT dash. We have taken the tangent as TT dash. And here normal we have taken as n dash, right? That should be taken. So at the extreme bottom I going to take it. So for which, how to draw a guidelines, parallel lines? It should be 5 mm gap, okay? It should maintain 5 mm. It should maintain 5 mm. 5 mm. Okay, fine. Right, T dash as tangent, and next open the guidelines with the 5 mm gap. Always the rules is the same. And next write n dash as normal. Normal. What is next? As about the dimension. Here we have taken all the dimensions in the standardized manner in mm. So it should be given as a note. So below it, open lengthy guideline with the same 5 mm gap and write all dimensions. All dimensions are in mm. Okay, so then we can also write about the scale, since we have not reduced or enlarged any scale. So we have just drawn the diagram, the measurement as it is in the question. What we can do is just capture with the guidelines and write scale. Just write a scale. So here you can make it. Just write a scale. One is to one. Okay. And then you have to give the title. You have to give the name for the curve. So the drawn diagram, the drawn profile is what? A parabola, right? So here you can take a guideline and write the given curve is a parabola. Okay, write the given curve is a parabola. I'm just writing only the parabola. You can write the given curve is a parabola. Parabola. Then here we have the directrix. That also must be noted. So in the directrix, you can take the leader line and capture a guideline and write in the capital letter directrix. Directrix. And here we have the axis. Okay. So take comma and write axis. It also should be written inside the guideline with 5 mm gap. Right? So I hope you understood how to construct the parabola. Okay? Thank you.